Hey everyone, Eric with Rockin' HTV. Tonight I'm going to assemble a single combine Donahue trailer, or a Donahue combine trailer. This is just a classic trailer that's just really cool. Made in the 70s, 80s, used for hauling custom combines up and down the highways for years and years, and have now since been retired. This is just a great little model. 3D printed, combined designed between me and several other people who all crowdsourced this, and it's been since updated by Mock Farms, which is kind of cool, and it's even better than the original. But long story short, this is in my Shapeway store and I need a video on how to assemble it, so here we go. It only comes in 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces in my left hand, and this is the magic right here. It's all one piece of black, strong and flexible. Strong and flexible plastic. It is quite durable. You know, we wanted something that was going to take a little abuse as guys put their models on it. Already comes with a hitch, so all you're going to do to this piece here is drill out some holes to make them just a little bit bigger so your axle slides nice and easy, and then put your axles on it. That's it. Here we go. You'll need to use at least a 16th inch bit. I'm using one just a hair bigger than a 16th for the axle holes. There's already holes there, but they just need cleaned out. It's really all you're doing here, just cleaning them out. You don't have to be pretty. Okay, that step is done. Boom. Now, I'm using some Moore's Farm Toys wheels and tires. These are their three-spoke tires. Nothing fancy about these. They run about $4 an axle. And then I'm using 16th inch rod right here as the axle. So you just slide that through. And then, well, it works best if you aren't all thumbs. There we go. Okay, and then I like to keep my thumb over there and then just kind of push that axle in. Okay, now to make this all fit nice and beautiful, you're gonna need to cut that axle about 3/16 of an inch away from the end of the frame. And there we go. Push it. And then you just slide the other tire on just like so, and then push them together. Now you're gonna have to keep these pretty tight. You can't have a whole lot of slack. You'll notice on either side of these tires right here, you don't have much room. But on the originals, there wasn't a whole lot of room to play around in there either. And then they will spin free. Okay, let's do another one just for luck. So you can see these are not a complicated model. And if you're going for a retro look on your model farm, or maybe you know someone that used to run one of these, you've got a cheap and easy gift for them this holiday season, or for a birthday or something like that, or just because they're your buddy. Okay, so the body of this trailer is now complete. All we have to do is add ramps, and these bad boys are done. Here we go. They come wired up together just like this, so you'll need a pair of side cutters to cut the wires off. They're called wires, they're just little sprues that hold them together. That way, when they're done printing, the folks at Shapeways can find them easy. So all these little wires, you just take your side cutters. And cut them off. Okay, now they're even wired up to go together. Once you cut the sprue off, they're pretty much wired up to go together. So right here, you can kind of see these parts that are flared out. Those are going to go together, and those are going to be your pivot points. So when you put them on and you unfold this bad boy, they unfold and then don't go back over themselves. You'll understand once I'm done. Now, to wire these up, there's already holes in these, so you don't need to drill them out or even clean them out for that matter. Use you some tiny piano wire. That's what this is. You could use brass rod. It's softer and easier to work with. What I do is begin with making an L, just bending it 90 degrees on one end. Okay. Then you put them together and run the rod through. Ooh, and watch out, don't stick it in your finger. Now, one thing I have noticed on these ones that I've put together thus far is bend these to the back side. So this pivot point here, your hinge, bend that toward the hinge side. And surprisingly, you can bend that and not bust your ramp, which is remarkable how strong that stuff is. At least I haven't busted a ramp yet. Cut off any excess. And this one is done. See how that works? Perfect. Let's do the other one while we're here. Again, on one end, we're going to make an elbow, a 90 degree bend, put them together, and slide that rod through. And of course, we're going to bend it to the hinge side. Okay. And I overbent that, but you know, that doesn't really matter. Cutting off excess from one side and then cutting the rest off of the other. Okay, two hinges are finished. Now, let's put them on the trailer. Again, 90 degrees going out of the gate like so. And just like the hinge, the holes are there. Everything lines up nice and neat and clean. Whoops. And then just run it through. Again, as I mentioned on the ramps, see this little elbow, that 90 degree bend? Make that point to the bottom side of the trailer, okay? If you don't, what will happen is, if you leave that up, that sharp point's going to get in the way of your ramp folding clean. So get that thing out of the way, point it down, just like so. Okay, so I flipped the trailer over, and now all I'm going to do is just bend this 90 degrees again by hand and cut off the excess. Ta-da! Look at that. Perfect. One more, and this bad boy is done. And we've done this in approximately, what, 10 minutes? Which makes that awesomer, because then you don't spend much time in assembly. And this thing is printed in black, strong, and flexible, as I mentioned earlier, which makes it even nicer, because I guess I'm doing this backwards, aren't I? I don't paint black strong and flexible normally. I just leave it. And for my purposes, this thing's gonna reside on a shelf. It's not going in a competition. And even if it was on a display, I wouldn't paint it anyways, because it's black and that's good enough for me. I'm not too darn picky most days. Okay, again, making sure that wire, watch out, I'm gonna just turn that south, bend that dude around, and ta-da. We have it. We have money. All right. Now we'll cut off the excess again. And you can come in here and cut them even shorter if you want. If they're pokey, cut them shorter. You don't have to worry about it. Just do it. Ta-da. Look at there. I think we can call that D-U-N done. Now, for a test drive, because it'd be dumb not to, right? Let's see how this looks with the combine on it. Okay, count to five, people. Okay, sorry for the break in the action, but I had to get him a couple more combines just for fun. We can't do this unless we adequately play with them. Hello. Why do we do all this if we're not going to play with our models, right? Here we go. Okay, the Ertl. This is a 7720 rebadged and 8820. The ramps have a hard time staying up with one of these, and you'll notice back here, there. So you may have to get a little creative to get the ramps to operate real nice with an 8820 on it. This thing, this trailer here, is actual manufacturer spec. Okay, so it is exactly the way the manufacturer has it. Unfortunately, the Ertl and the trailer don't get along so well. Either way, that's some formality you can get around. Now, this is an IH 1460 rebranded and 1480, and you'll see that the ramps behave for the most part here on that one. Whoops, getting a little crazy there. And you'll notice I put aftermarket tires on these to make it look a little beefier, like a 1480. Then we have an Ertl TR97. That is just a little shorter than the other two, and those ramps stay up perfectly. Ta-da! So there you go, guys. This is the Donahue Retro Combine Trailer. This was a partnership between several other builders and I, and with some mods done by Mock Farms, it's even better than the original version. And this is the way custom harvesters used to haul these machines routinely back in the day. This was exactly the way these were hauled. Makes a pretty cool little model. Okay, guys. Thanks so much for watching. As you can see, this is a pretty easy model to put together. These are available in my Shapeways store. Just Google or just search Rockin' H on Shapeways and you'll find my store without any trouble and all the models I have. Thank you for watching, and like, comment, share. Appreciate it. See ya.